Good evening, friends. This is your Jawahar. Welcome you to a short lecture. Today, the topic to be covered is the Rohingya genocide issue. Well, for some time we have been looking at this subject. So, let me tell you what is this subject is all about. Mainly because Aung San Suu Kyi has been leading the Myanmar's delegation before the International Court of Justice. That is why this has become very important, both from examination point of view and also from other point of view. Well, the Rohingyas are the minority Muslims and ethnic group living in Rakhine district, Rakhine region of Myanmar. They have long been denied citizenship right and they have been treated as illegal immigrants. They were subjected to various difficulties because the majority is Buddhist group. These people, Rohingyas, they were subjected to different difficulties because they were denied the fundamental right of a citizen. Well, these people, they were subjected to difficulties. It is not only like restrictions relating to their employment, the restriction relating to family planning, and there were also some restrictions placed by the government because they need to get the permission of the government before they get wedded. So in that case, when they apply to the government, there is nothing wrong in applying to the government, but if they apply, they need to send the photograph of the bride without a scarf on the headgear. Number two, the bridegroom should be completely shaven before the photograph is taken. This has affected their religious sentiments. And this the targeting of the Rohingyas has been going ahead for some time. Well, recently they formed what is known as the Arakan Rohingya Salvation Army. Arakan Rohingya Salvation Army to kind of fight for their rights. This has been treated by the government, the military government in Myanmar as a terrorist group working against the government. So, in August 2017, the big genocide was taken up against this Rohingya group because the hundreds of villages where these minority Rohingyas were living were targeted by the military, and even it was reported those people who were fleeing from that area, looking asylum elsewhere from their country, were also shot dead. How far it is true, we do not know, but these are some of the reported versions. There are more than about 7 lakh to 9 lakh Rohingyas have taken asylum in Bangladesh, Thailand and Malaysia. As regards to India is concerned, India refused to provide refuge status to these people. India is not ready to accept them. Because the refugee problem is to be looked at as sharing the resources with the local people. And there is a convention, there is also an international organization to take care of the refugees. But these people become stateless people. Well, what is a genocide? Genocide is nothing but both physically and mentally torturing or destroying a particular group of people based on ethnicity, race or color or religion or any other differences. But this complete destruction of a group is known as a genocide. Suicide means a person who is extincting his own life. That is a person who finishes his life. It's called a suicide. A homicide is one who finishes the life of the other person. And a regicide is one who kills the king. And this genocide means a particular group is being targeted and they are wiped off. This genocide has been done by, you know, during the period of Hitler, the Jews were subjected to genocide. And the same thing now is happening. And the case has been taken to ICJ, International Court of Justice. That's the only UN organization that is functioning outside New York. And it is in the Hague City in Netherlands. And here, this ICJ will be hearing. Because who is the petitioner? Gambia. Gambia is a Western African country and also a member of the IOI, Organization of Islamic Countries. So this is a 57 members organization. Essentially, basically, it is a Muslim countries or Muslim ruled countries, Muslim majority countries. They have complained against Myanmar for violating the UN Genocide Convention of 1948. And it came into effect in 1951. As regards India, it signed it in 1949 and ratified it in 1951. But who are the people to be proceeded against? It can be proceeded against by any individual or group of individual, or it can be against government officials or the government itself. Well, who can take up the case to the ICJ? ICJ, nobody can take up the case except the state. That is why Gambia has taken up the case to the ICJ. Now, Aung San Suu Kyi, who was known for her fight for democracy and for which she has taken up what you call on the lines of Mahatma Gandhi, she did fought her battle and she was awarded with the Nobel Prize for Peace in 1991. Now, her name gets besmirched because of this. Now she has to go before ICJ and has to argue that these people are terrorist group, hence they were attacked. So it will be very difficult. And let us see this. What is the role of the ICJ? ICJ, you know, it consists of 15 judges. They are appointed on a rotational basis and their term is for 9 years, not for 6 years or 5 years, for 9 years. And they uphold, because all the members of the UNO, they have already taken an undertaking that they will abide by the orders of the International Court of Justice. And also it gives some opinion. And it is a very important organization because the UN Charter has approved this. Now, the Myanmar is also a member state of the United States. So, whatever the judgment given by the ICJ should be upheld, should be adhered by both the countries. Okay, with this, we'll meet with you on some other subject. Thank you.